Welcome to Wall Street Mojo. To know more about this video LINEST, watch the video till the end. And also, if you're new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon that's given below. Welcome everyone, and today we are going to learn something really different. That's LINEST function in Excel. This is a part of a statistical function, and we're going to learn this in a much more detailed format. So to begin with, first of all, we need to learn some of the integrities of this particular topic. Well, see, this function is a built-in function in MS Excel. LINEST function in Excel is used to calculate what we call as the statistical, if you say that statistical line or for a line, it is used and it is the least square method. And it returns an array because that describes the straight line that basically best fits the given data. Okay, how does the LINEST work? When you start with is equal to LINEST, you get known y's, constant stats. Well, the equation for the line is y is equal to mx plus b. Okay, now y is over here m1 into 1, okay, plus m2 into 2 plus m3 into 3, right? So the LINEST in Excel has two arguments, of which one is required, where the known y's, it is required parameter and indicates the set of y values already known in the relationship. That is, y is equal to mx plus b. Okay. Now, if the range of the known y's in a single column, each column of the known x's are interpreted as a separate variable. So if the range of the known y's is the single row, each row of the known x's is interpreted as a separate variable. Okay, let's learn about something called known x's. It is an optional parameter, and basically that indicates the set of the x values that is already known in the relationship. And the relationship is y is equal to, okay, mx, you can say, plus b. Okay, now the range of the known x's can have one or more set of variables. So if one of the variable is used, the known y's and the known x's can be the range of any shape. So if they have equal dimension, so if more than one variable is used, y's must be a vector, that is a range with a height of what we call as one row or a width of one column. Okay, now there's another thing that's called the constant. Now it is an optional parameter and a separate, it represents a logical value that is true or false, specifying whether to force the constant p to be equal to zero. So if the constant, let's say, is true, or it's skipped, b is calculated normally, and if the constant is false, b is set equal to zero, and then the m values are adjusted to fit the y equal to mx. Now let's talk about the stats. Okay, so it is basically an optional parameter and represents a logical value that is probably a true or a false. Okay, and just specifying whether to return the additional regression in statistics or not. Now, let's say it turns out to be true, so the LINEST in Excel returns the additional regression statistics, and as a result, the returned array is mn or mn minus 1, and so on and so forth. So if the stats are false or skip, LINEST in Excel returns only the m coefficient and the constant b. So how to use the LINEST function in Excel, that is what we are going to learn. Now the set function is basically a worksheet function, and as a worksheet function, the LINEST function in Excel can be entered as a part of a formula and in a cell of worksheet. So you need to refer to a couple of examples. Let's look at the example given, and each example will cover a different use case implemented using the LINEST function in Excel. Well, we'll start with the first example. As shown above here, there are some of the known y's and some of the known x's. We are going to learn the result, that is the regression saying is equal to LINEST. Okay, then there are known y's b2 to b5, comma the known x's. And resultant answer is 2. So as shown in the above formula here, if you see, well, the formula is b2 to b5 is known y's and c2 to c5 is known x's, and the third parameter, that is constant, is left blank, so it will be calculated. And the fourth parameter, that is the stats, is marked with false. Okay, well, let's take another example, example number 2. We'll try and interpret is equal to sum. Okay, we are going to use inside the same LINEST, use the LINEST function here. Inside that, we'll say this are our known x's. Okay, I'm sorry, not this one, in the same one, b2 to the b5. Okay, just use sum function here inside that LINEST. Okay, so now as shown here, the LINEST function above here, it has the same thing. What you can use here is equal to LINEST, same the known y's, comma the known x's, express, it's showing us 0. Okay, so now based on this, there are some of the things that you should remember. The first one is that when entering an array constant, such as like known x's as an argument, commas can be used. Okay, it can be used to separate values that are present in the same row, and semicolons can be used to separate the rows. Well, a separate character may vary depending on the native region that is setting apart. Now, the values predicted by the regression equation may not be valid if they are outside the range of y values used to determine it is basically used to determine the equation. So there are some of the formulas that returns array must be entered as an array formula. Fourth is that when there are only one independent x variable, slope, okay, and y x intercept values can be directly can be calculated by using formulas like slope, y intercept formulas. Fifth, a straight line, you know, can be described as a slope. Okay, a straight line can be described as a slope, and a y intercept. Okay, now the slope m, to find the slope of a line often interpreted as m, and for a line for the point b, x1 and x2, x2, x3, and so on and so forth. And same goes with the y interpretation. So the equation straight line is y is equal to mx plus b, and once the values of m and b are known, any point of line can be calculated by putting the y equal to or x values into equation. So that's it for this particular topic. I thank you everyone for joining the session. If you have learned and loved watching this video, then don't forget to hit the like button, comment on this videos, and subscribe to our channel for all the latest updates. Thank you everyone.